would be nice to have machinery to do this. But on the upside, burning our own calories, I have to keep my eyes peeled for snakes, puff adder and cobra. So to recap, we took this as a piece of dry, dead, eroded felt. We took that, tilled it, put oat seeds in there, got them growing. Not as productive as it should have been. They went to seed. We're going to get some feed from it. And I'm leaving a lot of residue behind so we can leave some carbon and nutrients in the soil, until we can get the animals to forage here and create an automatic nutrient cycle there. So the crop residue is now there to prevent us from mining out nutrients and carbon and taking it away. And then we're going to replace this, probably have to till it again, replace it with a mix of corn and squash and alfalfa and whatever we can mix in, just to get a living root system in there again. From 1 or 2 square meters, I can do one pile like that. And then in other areas like here behind me, it gets sparser, so it doesn't make sense to cut, because you cut 3 or 4 square meters to make the same size. So I'll let the goats browse that. More productive, easier for us, and they'll enjoy walking around here for a few days eating this stuff. And then I'll stash the good stuff back in the feed store. I'm making bushels, little piles, about 6, 7, 8 kilograms each, using the bale twine from the purchased bales that we had lying around. But I'm gonna stop here, because I noticed that productivity goes down when I start cutting the sections that are very sparse. So I'll bring in the goats to graze here tomorrow for the next few days, graze it down as far as possible. It's going to be way more productive and easier for us, and then we can sow back in there.